Dear students, this is Kuldeep Singh Gaur from Department of Zoology. Today we are going to study the broad classification of group core data. In Latin, cordatus means having a cord. And in the last lecture, I had enlisted some general characters of chordates, which were bilateral symmetry, metameric segmentation, they being coelomate, deuterostome, they are triploblastic, having ventral heart and hepatic portal system, and three types of kidney were found in the chordates. Those were protonephric, mesonephric, and metanephric kidneys, and the nervous system was dorsal, and many of them have had postanal tail. The chordates have been divided into two groups. One is protochordata, another is urochordata. Protochordates were also called as lower chordates, and they do not have a cranium, that's why they have been placed under acrania. All of them, they are exclusively marine and are having protonephric kidney. Their coelom is enterocoelous, whereas eucordates, which are the higher chordates, they have cranium, that's why they are also called as craniata, and they have schizocoelous type of coelom. That means the advanced chordates, they have schizocoelous coelom, whereas the lower chordates, they have enterocoelous coeloms. Now the protochordates have been divided into three subphylums: hemichordata, urochordata, and cephalochordata. Hemichordates, hemi means half and chordata means the chordates. These are also called as the delochordata, and they are having two classes, enteroneusta and pterobranchia. Enteron means gut and neustos means breathers. Those animals who breathe by their gut, they are placed under the class enteroneusta. The enteroneust also called as acorn worms, whereas pterobranchia, they have feather-like gills and have U-shaped intestine. But owing to some apprehensions regarding hemichordates being in direct lineage with chordates, they have now been placed under invertebrata, because the notochord present in them is a suspicious, and that's why it has been named as stomochord. These days we do not study hemichordata under the group protochordates. So we have only two subphylums remaining in protochordata group. One is urochordata, another is cephalochordata. Urochordates are having notochord in their tail. Aura means tail, that's why they are called as urochordates. The urochordates have three classes: Acidacea, Thalesia, and Larvacea. Acidacea are generally called as sea squirts, because they let out a jet of water whenever they are disturbed. Thalesia are salps, and they display alternation of generation in their life cycle. And the Larvacea is a unique class of urochordata which never undergoes metamorphosis. The reason being, they are so satisfied with their larval stage that they did not feel any urge to get metamorphosed. The cephalochordate is another subphylum of group protochordata. Cephalo means head, derived from word cephal means head, and they have notochord throughout their body length. projecting into the head region. Only class they are having is Leptocardi. They have a fish-like body and small in sizes. So these are the this is the explanation of protocordates, and now we are having urochordata, the higher chordates. They have only one subphylum, which is called as vertebrata. Vertebratus, in Latin, vertebratus means having backbone. These vertebrates have been divided into two divisions, agnatha and nathostomata. A means not, nathos means jaw. That means agnatha have absence of true jaws, and they also have paired appendages wanting. Nathos means jaw and stoma means mouth. That means these animals, or the division, they have true jaws and also they have paired limbs. The nathostomes, as I told you, have absence of paired appendages, and their internal ear is having only two semicircular canals. We have two classes among nathostomes, agnatha. One is ostracodermy. Ostracon means shell and derma means skin. They have heavily armored skin, and they are the world's first vertebrate, and they look like fishes. Cyclostome, another class of agnatha, are parasites, the only parasites in the chordate kingdom, and are scavengers also. Cyclostomes also do not have jaws, although they do have cranium. Now, the nathostomata means the animals who have jaws have been divided into two superclasses. One is species, another is tetrapoda. Nathos means jaw and stoma means mouth, as I've told you right now. Species have been divided into three classes. One is placodermy, chondrichthyes, and ostichthyes. The placoderms were the first jawed fishes on this planet, and chondrichthyes are the fishes who have cartilage as their endoskeleton. The speciality of chondrichthyes is that their males have claspers, that is, copulatory organs, and they have placoid scales all over the body. The operculum is absent in chondrichthyes. That means their gill slits are laid open and not covered without covered with a lid, which is called as operculum. Ostichthyes, on the other hand, have an endoskeleton of bone, and their gill slits are covered with operculum. This is the superclass Piscis. Ostracoderms and cyclostomes, they also look like fishes, but they were not placed under Piscis, and because they do not have jaws, that's why they have been placed separately under agnatha. Ostracodermy and placodermy have now extincted from the planet, and no specimen is sighted. Nathostomes have another superclass, tetrapoda. That means having four limbs. And among tetrapoda, we have four classes, amphibia, reptilia, aves, and the most advanced, mammalia. Amphibia are the animal which can live both on land and in water. The reason being they developed lungs for air breathing. Reptiles are the creeping animals and are the first true land vertebrates. Amphibia were not the first true land vertebrates because they have to go to water for their reproduction. The reason being they lay eggs which are fragile. This deficiency has been overcome by the reptiles because they develop leathery shell and amnion around their developing embryo. Amnion is a watery jacket which holds the developing embryo in a reservoir of fluid, and this was an epoch-making evolutionary development in reptiles, which has led them to explore the terrestrial environment without going back to the reservoirs or water as amphibia had to do that. The reason being they developed amnion, which protects their embryo even on the harsher conditions of the land. Aves are the birds. Latin avis means birds. Birds were the flying animals and they had certain adaptations to fly, and they are termed as glorified reptiles because they are closely related to the reptiles, having some of their characters in common with the reptiles. Mammalia class having mammo, that means having breast. This is the most advanced class. Now, right from ostracoderms to the amphibia, all the animals including ostracoderms, cyclostomes, placodermy, chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, and amphibia, they are placed under an amniota because they don't have amnion to protect their developing embryo. Whereas the reptiles, aves, and mammals, they are placed under amniota because they have amnion around their embryo, which protects it from the desiccation and other harsher conditions of the terrestrial environment. This is all in the broad classification of chordates. Thank you very much.